Hey guys, it's Nick here with another After Effects tutorial. Oh my god, I made 2 in 1 week. Can't believe it. So, anyway, I was making this new intro for my site, for my videos, and I thought it was a pretty cool effect. It got that hand-drawn kind of look. And I was able to do it just in After Effects with some simple effects and shape animations, and I want to show you how to do it. So let's get into it. Hope you love it. So here I got my Motion Dad logo, and I made each letter a separate layer that I turned into a shape. And I'm just going to show you how to do this on one. I'm not going to animate each and every one of these. But basically, I just go in and animate the path, and I work backwards. I start with keyframe of the letter M and go backwards and start gathering up some anchor points and just start dragging these up with, I'm holding down shift and hitting the arrow up like that. Go back. Drag a few more. Actually, I'm going to drag the rest of these. Like that, and then seems like 4 keyframes is the magic number here. And then kind of start, that's the basic animation, then you want to kind of start finessing some of these things. So I want these to kind of blob into the middle. And then maybe set a final keyframe here and go back to this one. And I want it to kind of bounce in so it looks a little bit more natural. So now we got that kind of bounce to the letter, and that looks pretty good. The other thing that I'm going to do is I got this blob effect, which is like a preset from this guy over on Dribbble. Just Google blob effect and Dribbble and After Effects, and you will find it. And it's just a preset. Thanks to this guy, I use this a lot, and it's very helpful. It's just a preset of 2 separate effects, and Scotty just uses them very cleverly. Levels alpha effect, which we're not going to mess with, and the Gaussian blur. And it just right off the bat turns this into a blob, but you can modify it by playing with this blurriness. So what I did was I started more like around 50 because I still wanted it to get that kind of square. I want it to look somewhat like an M, and I keyframe that and then go over to 0 or even like 2, and then I got a very blobby effect here. So let me do one other letter. I'll do this O, and the reason I want to do it is because, let me delete this stuff. This is actually 2 paths, and they're merged together, but it shouldn't really matter. I'm going to create keyframes for both. You're just working with 2 paths instead of 1, but the process is the same. And like that. This is a basic stretch, and I feel like you could do more stuff with this. But I just wanted to show that whether you're working with one path or 2, it doesn't really matter. So now that I have this M done, I'm going to show you how I got that wiggle in this one. If you look closely, there's this kind of stop motion wiggle That's really easy to do. Use a wiggle pass, but you have to use it in a different way than just the default way. So what you do is go to add and then wiggle pass. And right off the bat, I already have this kind of set up, so I'm just going to delete that. Right off the bat, this gives me a very rigid and animated look, which could be good for some things, but not what I'm trying to do. So first of all, I don't want it to animate on its own. I'm going to keyframe the animation myself. And so I'm going to turn that to zero. So now I just have a very rigid path. So I'm going to change this to smooth because I want it to have that hand-drawn look. And the detail is going to be zero because I want it to be very still blobby and kind of like I was, you know, drawing straight lines or painting straight lines, but I couldn't get it perfect. So it's just that kind of man-made imperfection. And then size, I'll do 5. And that's looking pretty good. And now to animate this, I'm just going to animate the random seed and withhold keyframes. So basically, picture you have your hand drawing this and you want it to hold, and you have three different drawings looping. So use that hold keyframe to get that look, and then go up 3 frames, and then go to 10 or whatever, it doesn't matter. Just another one. 2, 3, 20. And now I have like 3 separate drawings of the same letter, and I'm going to just loop them. Went too far. There we go. Anyway. And there. And then I'm going to have to bring these keyframes back because you want them to be kind of be wiggling the whole time, but it's more noticeable when it gets in place. And that's all there is to it. There's a couple other little finesse type things. Like for one, if I were to hand draw this, in Photoshop or something, I would probably draw in 12 frames per second, but to change the composition settings from 24, or 30 frames to 12 frames would give me a 12 frame per second video clip, which is not what I want, when I'm placing this in something else. So I want to emulate that look by going to new adjustment layer and posterize time. Did it happen? No, it didn't. All right, there we go. And then just if you put 12 here, it's going to make it look like it's 12 frames, but you're still going to get that 24 frame per second composition. So that gives it a little bit more of that kind of handmade kind of look. And one other thing is, once I made this animation, that looked pretty good, but I had to find a way to get my video and animation tag in. And I've done this tutorial in the past, this kind of reveal of the text. And basically what it boils down to is taking a simple choker effect and keyframing it. And this is going to, it's meant to choke the alpha mask, from, you know, to modify like a green screen or something. But I find it's useful for text to give it this kind of same type of organic look. So start at like 96, keyframe it, and when you want it to come in, go to 0. And actually, what I did in the final version was made it more like -1 because I just felt like it had like a kind of a nice glow to it or something. And I feel like that still matches that kind of hand-drawn look without being exactly the same thing. So yeah, that's all there is to it. And if you find this helpful, please leave me a comment. If you have a better way to do this sort of thing, let me know as well. I feel like this is a very popular thing right now. And to be honest, it's just a pain to draw it every time. You just want to have that look and you want to do it quickly. And this is very quick to do and looks pretty good. So thanks and see you next time.